Keys are a key part of VSPlay and are building blocks of any light show that you produce. They contain lighting information that will be played back as part of your playlists. The VSPlay cue library contains three main types: static scenes, dynamic cues, and effects. As the name suggests, dynamic cues contain animation. Dynamic cues are created by recording anywhere from 1 to 32 universes at frame rates of anything between 1 to 60 frames per second. After each dynamic cue is made, you can use it in a playlist timeline as part of a show, adding fading times, modifying brightness and layering it with other cues, and setting play times or infinite loops. There's no software limit to the number of dynamic cues you can make, and the output can be switched between streaming ACN, ArtNet, or physical DMX on the settings page at any time. The VSPlay has a huge user accessible storage capacity of up to 8GB for cues, triggers, events, and interfaces. To calculate the theoretical file size of a dynamic cue, the size of a single 1-universe DMX frame, which is 518 bytes, should be multiplied by the quantity of universes being captured, then the quantity of frames being recorded per second, and finally, the duration of the recording in seconds. If we work this backwards, it means you can easily achieve days of recording time. Better still, if you want to go past this, you can always insert a microSD card into the front of the device, up to 64GB. To start creating dynamic cues, we'll navigate to the green add icon at the top of the cue library page. Select dynamic cue, and then select recording control. This allows for a start trigger to be defined to begin the recording, using any trigger protocol or digital input that the VSPlay works with. My personal go-tos are the SACN, ArtNet and DMX triggers. When the channel level you define is met, recording begins. It stops when the channel level falls below this. By building this channel into the cue sequence in your lighting desk, you can ensure the start and stop times execute perfectly. If you don't want to use this function, select manually and then press the pencil icon to edit. This brings up the cue creation interface. We'll define a cue name. This accepts spaces, non-alphanumeric characters, and anything else you want to add in to make naming easy. On the top right-hand side of the interface, we can set the channel range of each universe being recorded. If I go to ArtNet, we can see I'm set to record 32 universes from 0 to 31. I can reduce the number by toggling them off and setting specific internal universes. I can also define how the data is saved. For example, if I want to record one universe of data to the first four internal universes of the VSPlay, I could set the first four to universe 0. As you can see, we can capture from ArtNet, streaming ACN, or DMX from the back of the device by selecting the appropriate tab. I'm going to set everything back and then record ArtNet from our ENTTEC LED mapper software coming from a PC on the same network. If set to manual, pressing start recording begins the recording instantly. If set to receive a trigger, it'll arm the system ready to receive that trigger. When completed, the output can be previewed before saving. At the top of the interface, we have the option to set a live preview. This duplicates what is recording in real time onto your outputs. This is useful when recording from ArtNet or streaming ACN, then outputting what you're recording onto the DMX ports to view on your fixtures live. Make sure you're not recording and sending from the same protocol and universe on broadcast. This could result in clashes or unwanted data feedback loops. Next, we have the perfect loop option. This should be used for loop content only. The VSPlay compares the first few frames recorded and looks for a point that these repeat. When it identifies this repetition point, it automatically pauses the recording to create perfectly looped content. To demonstrate this, I'm going to send ArtNet from ENTTEC's LED mapping software ELM. As you can see, when it's started, values are being recorded. When the loop is completed, the VSPlay automatically stops recording content. After pressing stop and saving, these can be used in a playlist timeline in combination with the loop function and fade in and fade out capabilities for a flexible animated background content. If not using the perfect loop function, simply press stop. We hope this has been helpful. If you've got any questions, let us know in the comments below or get in touch with the team at enquiries.com. See you in the next one.